Welcome to the RFID Network News, the only globally syndicated news program dedicated to RFID technology. I'm Lou Sirico. In this edition for April 2011, how RFID technology is used to track elephants at the Dallas Zoo, a new RFID handheld from Hanna Enosis, a new desktop RFID reader from Thinkify, and the largest passive RFID tag we've ever seen. Stay tuned. Our top story for this April 2011 edition is how RFID technology is helping scientists study elephants at the Dallas Zoo. The Dallas Zoo has received praise from zookeepers around the world for their Giants of the Savannah exhibit. This unique habitat allows elephants, giraffes, and other species to roam freely together. What's also unique about the exhibit is the fact that the zoo is using RFID technology to track the movement of the elephants. The solution was designed and implemented by Cognitive Frequencies and uses the CSL Real-Time Location System, or RTLS, that our team reviewed last fall. Although RFID technology is used for tracking farm animals like cows, elephant tracking is, well, a much bigger challenge. The zoo wants to track the exact location of the elephants all the time, and the terrain has a number of obstacles, including a large watering hole and varying elevations. Stumpy is wearing an RTLS tag as an ankle bracelet. The RTLS anchors, or readers, are placed in the research towers and positioned to track the elephants as they move around. Stumpy's position is recorded every 30 seconds, and the data is overlaid on a map of the habitat. This information graphically shows researchers the places the elephants like to go, the other animals in the herd they spend the most time with, and how much exercise they're getting. The habitat and the use of RFID technology makes Giants of the Savannah a showcase for the Dallas Zoo and a wonderful example for other zoos around the world. We have three RFID product announcements for this month. The first is a new RFID handheld from Hanna Enosis.
The Rapid Handheld RFID Reader from Hanna Enosis is unlike any other RFID handheld our team has ever tested. It has a number of built-in features that make it unique. The unit is designed to accommodate high security applications, including financial payments, and uses a Unix-based operating system. It includes an ISO 7816 smart card reader, which allows operators to securely authenticate with a smart card and PIN number, a MagStripe reader, which allows the unit to process credit cards, and it even has a built-in 2-inch thermal printer. As an EMV Level 1 and Level 2 device, data encryption is supported for communication between the device and the server. It has an LCD display with 128 by 64 pixel resolution, 19-key keyboard for input, one USB and one serial port, as well as a headset jack. If you're working in a location without a wireless network, it has quad-band GPRS cellular communication with support for not one, but two SIM cards, which allows you to switch to a secondary wireless provider if there's no signal from the primary provider. It also gives you the ability to choose a carrier with a lower rate depending on your location. For outdoor operation, it has built-in GPS positioning and can associate GPS location information with RFID tag read data. The handheld is well balanced with a circular polarized antenna mounted in the center of the unit, not underneath. It's a full 1-watt UHF reader, and our initial benchmark tests found it has respectable read ranges. The rechargeable, removable lithium-ion battery is designed for 13 hours of operation and 21 hours of standby. What's most surprising is that even with all these features, it's priced at under $2,000. One of the lowest price points of any UHF RFID handheld. You'll find all the specifications on the RFID Network website, and we'll publish a complete review with benchmark tests later this month.
Up next, a new desktop RFID reader from Thinkify. I have in front of me the TR200 reader, which has a single antenna connector. We have two antennas, a small omnidirectional 50 ohm antenna, and a more common circular polarized patch antenna. We're going to see just how well the reader works with these two antennas.
The InSight TR200 is an ISO 18006C and EPC Global Class 1 Generation 2 compatible UHF RFID reader. It's designed for desktop and office applications where an enterprise reader is overkill for the requirements. The reader uses a USB port for power and connectivity. After we installed the Thinkify demonstration software, we plugged in the reader to our laptop and started reading tags in less than a minute. Since the reader is powered by USB, it can operate using a laptop's battery, which makes it very portable. We could easily filter and encode tags. We set up the TR200 to be a commissioning station. Here we are commissioning asset tags for electronic equipment. We were even able to encode tag data in ASCII mode, which allowed the tag data to match the equipment's pre-existing tracking number. The reader also has a keyboard wedge feature that allows RFID tag data to be inserted directly in an application, kind of the same way a barcode scanner does. Switching between antennas was easy and we didn't have to turn off the reader. Even though the reader is powered by USB, we still achieved some very good performance. In benchmark testing, the TR200 averaged about 1.5 meter read distances with the small antenna and averaged over 3 meters with a circular polarized patch antenna. When we looked under the hood, we were very surprised to find more air than electronics. The TR200 is powered by a tiny module that Thinkify also sells. Thinkify offers a developer's kit that includes everything you need to get started reading tags within minutes of opening the box, and it's priced at only $475. Given the features, price, and performance, we have to give the Thinkify TR200 the RFID Network Best in Class Award for desktop RFID readers.
Given its size, you may think that this is actually an antenna designed to connect to an RFID reader. In reality, it's the largest passive RFID tag we've ever seen. This is the innovative RFID long ear tag, and our team recently had the opportunity to put it to the test in the real world.
The innovative RFID long ear tag is an ISO 18006C and EPC Global Class 1 Generation 2 compatible passive RFID tag. What makes this tag unique is its size. It's the largest passive RFID tag we've ever tested. 83.8 centimeters long by 23.8 centimeters wide by 2.87 centimeters thick. Given its size, the tag is lighter than we expected at 524.5 grams, or just over 18 ounces. It's designed to be mounted on metal using 5mm bolts or rivets. It's water resistant and can operate in temperatures of negative 40 to 85 degrees Celsius. The tag is tuned for FCC regions, that's 902 to 928 megahertz. It contains an Impinj Monza 4 integrated circuit with 128 bits of user memory and 496 bits of APC memory. Given the size, our team decided to take it out and compare its maximum read distance to some other long-range RFID tags.
Here we are doing long-range performance testing of a variety of different RFID tags. I've got my reader set up with two circular polarized antennas, not linear, but circular. They're set up in a bistatic mode though. One is in transmit, one is in receive. Because we're at a baseball field, you can easily judge the distance that we get with the different types of RFID tags that we're testing.
With the help of a team of junior engineers, we were able to read the long ear just over 150 feet away. That's impressive for a passive RFID tag. The tags that read further away are battery-assisted passive tags. We'll publish more detailed benchmark results in a future edition.
That wraps it up for the April 2011 edition of the RFID Network News. If you have news related to RFID technology, we'd like to know. Please visit us on the web at rfid.net. Thanks for watching.